Last class I have told you about m is equal to 0. This varies for binary number floating value. So I will just explain you with an example here. So we will take this example 0.0110 base 2. Okay, this m is equal to 0 varies here. I have told you r is equal to base value, that is 2, and then here n is the number that is given. Okay, that is 0.0110. I have told you this. So I will tell you the same formula as we are applying to binary number which is in a decimal part. R power n minus r power minus n minus n. This is the formula, same formula we are just going to use here. Okay, I have told you r is a base value and n is the number of digits that is given. Okay, here the small n here refers to the number of digits that is in integer part. See, here in integer part, the total number of digits in integer part. Okay, total number of digits in integer part. I will explain you briefly. See, here 0.0110, this is the number which is given. We are going to find out the ones complement of this number. So total number of digits in integer part, this is the integer part. Okay, total number of digits here is 0. Okay, so n is equal to 0. We'll just take this value in integer part. There is no value, so n is equal to 0. There is no integer value in this. Integer means like 10111, something like that. There is no integer part in this because it is a floating value. So we are taking n is equal to 0. Okay, are you clear with this? Then m, I have told you about m is equal to 0 in the previous class, in the integer part of binary number. Here the m value refers to number of fractional part. Okay, number of fractional part. Here the number of fractional part, which means the value given is 0.0110. okay, here the number of fractional part, which is 0110, that is 4. Value of number of fractional part is 4. I think you are clear with this, because 0.0110, the total number in the fractional part is 0110, that is equal to 4. So that is number is equal to 4, m is equal to 4. So we will substitute in this formula rn minus rm, r power minus m minus n. So r power, I have told you n, about n, that is the total number of digits in integer part. There is no integer value because it is a floating value, so it is 0. Minus r, we can substitute here 2, because it is r value, we know the base value, 2 power 0, and 2 minus m. So m, I have told you that number of fractional part, fractional part here is 4. 1 2 3 4, 4 digits were there. So 2 power minus 4 minus n, I have told you the n, the number which is given, 0.0110. okay, hope so you are clear with this. So 2 power 0 value is 1, minus we will take this to 1/2/4, which becomes positive, minus 0.0110. okay, 1 minus 1 divided by 2/4, which is 16, 2 power 4 is 16, minus 0.0110 is equal to 1 minus 1/16, value is equivalent to 0.0625 minus 0.0110. okay, I hope so you are clear with till this point. And here I will tell you the trick we are just going to use it here, because we have to find out this decimal point here. We'll just subtract, normal subtraction, 1 minus 0.0625 subtraction, will get 0.9375 minus 0.0110. So here, because as it is a floating value, we cannot find it a normal like with a conversion, like we cannot find like this 0.9375 and by 2. So we cannot do anything because it is a decimal value, and we cannot do like this method. This method is not applicable here, and I will just tell you the other method which we are just going to use here. So here we are just going to multiply by 2. We are not going to divide this number by 2. Instead, we are going to multiply by 2. So by 2, instead of dividing it, we are just multiplying it for the floating value. So 1.875 by multiplying. So the remaining value 1. So have this 1 here and put here 0.875 into 2. So here we will get 1.75. So have this 1 value here and put 0.75, again multiply by 2. So here we will get 1.5. So put this 1 here and have 0.5 multiplied by 2. So at last 0.5 into 2, we are getting 1.0, which is equal to 1. So the 0 is as 0.0, we will just truncate, or we will just take it out. Remainder is, that is, the remaining value is 1. So only the integer part is remaining. Again, we no need to multiply by 2 because at last we have got integer value which is equal to 1. So we have to take from top to bottom value, okay, from top to bottom, and 11141 minus 0.0110, and at last after the binary subtraction we'll just get 0.1001 base 2. Hope so you were clear with this video.